Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. In this video, I am taking up two conditions of the heart, myocarditis and pericarditis. I shall be describing their symptoms as well as the homeopathic treatment as available. A note of warning. In all sicknesses relating to heart, please do not depend on your own judgment. Consult a cardiac physician so that you are taken care of in time. The risk is too high. Do not take it. Myocarditis is an acute inflammation of the heart muscle, usually due to an infection. Acute means it comes suddenly and the intensity increases. Any problem which comes suddenly is called acute in medical terminology. The symptoms are pain in the chest, fever, fatigue, awareness of the abnormally rapid heartbeat. In later stages, breathlessness and swelling of the legs and ankles, numbness. So mark for these symptoms. Numbness, swelling of the legs and ankles, fever, pain, fatigue, abnormally rapid heartbeat. If not treated in time, myocarditis can lead to severe heart failure. Inflammation of the middle and the thickest layers of heart requires arsenic, iod-30, arsenic, iod-30. There are fatty deposits in the heart. Cholesterol level is high. Heart is chronically weak, flutters irregularly, there is a tendency to faint, there is severe pain in cardiac region travelling to the back, breathlessness on climbing steps. One of the best medicines for this condition is Digitalis 30. Digitalis 30. The myocardium is weak and dilated. It is inflamed. The problem comes suddenly. Pulse is abnormally low, but quickened by least movement. Sensation as if the heart would stop beating if the patient moved. Heavy breathing, worse on lying in the bed. Faintness and exhaustion, like during a mild illness such as cold or influenza. Dropsy of internal and external parts. The medicine is Digitalis 30, Digitalis 30. Mother tincture, in acute cases to stabilize the patient. 15 drop dose on sugar every 30 minutes. Reduce the dose as soon as the pulse stabilizes at 80 beats per minute. No liquid is to be taken for 20 minutes before or after each dose. Another medicine which can come handy is cactus mother tincture. 10 drops dose in water 4 times daily. If you find swelling on left foot, left leg and left hand. Mind you, all these three swellings are on the left side. There is acute or chronic inflammation of the heart. Cactus is very effective. Taking up pericarditis. It's inflammation of the pericardium, the double layered sac surrounding the heart. Usually it's an acute infection. The symptoms are like those of coronary thrombosis. A blockage of blood in a coronary artery reduces or stops the blood supply to the heart muscle. It is also called heart attack. While the angina pain subsides on rest, the myocardial infarction pain persists. Rather, it goes on increasing. Do not lose time. Contact a doctor. Call an ambulance. Rush the patient to the nearest intensive care unit. Constricting pain in the chest spreading into the neck is a leading symptom. Constricting pain in the chest spreading into the neck, into the left shoulder, the left arm, breathlessness, sweat, nausea, fear of death. The patient is running temperature. There is swelling in abdominal and in ankles. Constrictive pericarditis and with tenderness in the abdomen requires Bryonia 200, BRYONIA 200. The ankles are swollen, there is stitching pain in the chest, worse on motion. Mark the symptoms with stitching pain in the chest, worse on motion. Ankles swollen. The next medicine is colchicum, colchicum 30. Acute rheumatic cases, vertigo, at times loss of consciousness on sitting upright, difficult breathing, chest pain, tightness in chest, pulse is imperceptible. This is the leading symptom. Pulse is imperceptible. You hardly feel it. Colchicum comes handy. Digitalis 30, I have discussed above. The same doses. Spigelia 200 comes in handy, SPIGELIA, in rheumatic cases with piercing pain, violent palpitations, acute heart attack, worse by leaning forward. As I mentioned earlier, in any condition relating to heart, please consult a cardiologist. Don't sit idle. These problems can be very troublesome. You can't miss those symptoms, the pain in the heart region, the swelling in the ankles, legs, breathlessness, sweat is a very leading symptom, nausea, sometimes fever. If care is taken, the patient is given proper treatment or even shifted to hospital immediately. There is no reason why he cannot be cured. Fatality comes only when these symptoms are ignored. Thank you for listening to and visiting this site.